Today I'm excited to share with you a new way I've discovered to output a PAL S-Video signal, like from this PAL C64, to an NTSC monitor. Recently I was lucky enough to obtain a Commodore 1702 CRT monitor. I'd hoped to use this with my C64, however this 1702 monitor is from the US and only works with NTSC video signals. NTSC uses different colour encoding to PAL S-Video and the two are not compatible. When you output PAL S-Video, all you see on screen is a black and white picture. Now the C64 can output composite video as well as S-Video, and there are various composite PAL to NTSC converters you can pick up for around £20 from Amazon, and they'll do a good enough job if you're on a budget. But I wanted to use S-Video if possible because in general the video quality is going to be superior. Now I did a lot of research into this and I was shopping all sorts of sites trying to find a good solution, but I was unable to find a dedicated S-Video PAL to NTSC converter. So I tried a few different methods. The first I found was posted by Amiga Retro on YouTube, I'll link in the description, and involves converting a PAL S-Video to HDMI and then the HDMI back to NTSC S-Video by chaining a few devices, one of which is this. You can get a few variations of this and it takes a HDMI input and outputs S-Video, and you also have like a little toggle button to choose between NTSC and PAL. As well as this, you need a method of taking the S-Video signal from the C64 and converting it to HDMI. Now, Amiga Retro had a dedicated device for this. I didn't have that, and rather than order one, I just used a RetroTINK 2X because this takes S-Video and outputs HDMI. So from this to this, the monitor. And doing it this way, it worked fine. I still got a fairly decent picture on the monitor. I'd just say it was a little bit blurry. It wasn't as sharp as, say, the black and white PAL signal would be from the C64 directly to the monitor. So I wanted to find a better way to get a sharper, more detailed picture without using HDMI. So instead of using HDMI, I had the idea that it'd probably be better to try and convert to RGB SCART first. So working back from the monitor, I needed a solution to go from RGB to S-Video in NTSC, and I found one of these. This is a RGB to S-Video converter, which outputs NTSC S-Video signal. I got this from JS Technology. I'll also put a link in the description for this. And yeah, it works really well. It does require power. But I tested this with some of my other consoles, like my Mega Drive, which has RGB SCART output, and it rendered completely fine on the monitor in NTSC S-Video. In fact, I was really happy with the quality. So this part is good. The next thing we needed is a way to take the S-Video signal from the C64 and convert it to RGB. Now, I had one of these. This is a Panasonic DVD VHS recorder, and it outputs RGB SCART, and it also takes S-Video via the front panel. And essentially I was using this to convert S-Video to RGB, but this thing doesn't have very good video output. The image was very, very flickery. Although it worked, it was quite a sharp picture, it was too flickery. So that solution didn't really work out for me. So I tried something else. And this is what I managed to find. This is a Bitfunks OSSC add-on board, there's the manual for it. And yeah, this is designed to be like an add-on to the OSSC signal converter. And this has S-Video inputs, and rather than output HDMI like the OSSC, it outputs RGB SCART. So if you take this and you put your C64 S-Video into here, you can output SCART. And then from there, we can go to this box I had earlier, the RGB to S-Video converter in NTSC. So with these two devices, we can chain them together and get a much better signal. So this is the comparison between the HDMI and the RGB to S-Video. You see, the HDMI is more squished. It's like it's outputting at the wrong resolution, whereas the RGB matches the original input more accurately. The colours are better on the RGB and the image is sharper. So yeah, that's it. Now have fun with it instead of fiddling with cables all day long. So I hope this video helped, and yeah, have fun.